support for only $297.
Call my friends at MD Hearing and get the over-the-counter hearing aids that I use for you.
Call 800-420-8529.
I tend to deal with things in life with a sense of humor. My therapist on BetterHelp and I, we share this trait, and so we connect on a deeper level, and I'm more comfortable sharing things with him.
We are 30 minutes into the U.S. trading day on this Wednesday, March 27th. Here are the top stories we're following. Baltimore bridge disaster. Search operations still underway in Baltimore after a major commuter bridge collapsed yesterday after being struck by a container ship. We'll bring you the latest reporting from the grounds. AI outside of NVIDIA. What are the best ways to play the artificial intelligence craze outside just NVIDIA? We'll ask Kim Boca of Boca Capital. And housing market check. Home supply is finally ticking higher, but most homebuyers still face affordability issues. Redfin CEO Glenn Cohen joins in just a bit. To the rest of the market, and actually it's small caps that are leading the way, interestingly enough. Of course, the Russell 2000 currently up about 0.8%. But let's get back to the big story this week, and that is that six construction workers are presumed dead, with authorities set to resume recovery efforts following yesterday's bridge collapse in Baltimore. Cargo is being diverted to other major U.S. ports along the East Coast, and Maryland lawmakers are pushing for an aid package to help rebuild the bridge.
It's a huge economic impact on the country. This is not just impacting Maryland. This is impacting that farmer in Kentucky. It's impacting that auto dealer in Michigan. And so it is imperative that we get this bridge rebuilt. It's imperative that we get the Port of Baltimore back up and going. And it's not just about how we're supporting Maryland. This is about how we support the American economy.
Bloomberg's Kayla Lyons joins us live now from Baltimore with the latest. And Kayla,